But we're also really pleased to be here with our friends from three other libraries who are co-sponsoring this event. And they are the John Germain Library in Sag Harbor, the Hampton Library in Bridgehampton, and the Shelter Island Library on Shelter Island. So I think most of you know Valerie, which is why you're here. She was a native New Yorker. She's been a resident here for many years. She is a technical whiz, a computer whiz, a card-carrying member of the Actors Equity Association. And she has really brightened so many lives with her singing, with her concerts, with her classes over quite a number of years here on the East End. So I would have to say she is a real favorite of ours. I want to make a mention of the fact that on August 17th, she'll be doing a terrific show for the Rogers Memorial Library and a number of other libraries called Ladies of Liberty. It's a celebration of the centennial of suffrage and the history of women's rights in America. That will be a terrific show. So keep your eyes posted for that August 17th date. Valerie, I think we will go ahead and turn this program over to you, and we thank you so much for being with us tonight.
Thank you. Okay. Let's get started. Hi, everyone. How are you? So welcome to the Broadway Café. Today's featured musical is Hello, Dolly, and I'm Valerie DiLorenzo, and I'm going to be your hostess as we take a journey through this incredibly wonderful romp of a musical. So a couple of housekeeping things. Zoom is the new normal. I'm assuming that many of you might not be new to Zoom, but if you are, I just want to tell you a couple of things. If you're on a computer screen, there's a little chat button down at the bottom. And so if you have some feedback or suggestions for further musicals, things like that, you can communicate via that. If there's any kind of issues with sound and things like that, you know, you can put the message in there and hopefully Yvette can read it and I'll be able to get to it. If you're on an iPad or an iPhone, your controls to do the chat are up at the top. So it's a weird medium. We're going to do our best. I mean, I can see you when we're in a gallery view, but I'm going to do my best to take you along on a fun ride today. Now it's 5 o'clock. It's cocktail hour. I'm drinking a little toasted head Chardonnay today. And of course, have a little water. So make sure you get a little beverage as we talk about the fabulous musical, Hello, Dolly. And during the course of the program, you'll be able to play a sing-along with some lyrics if you'd like to. And if you just want to sit back and relax, you can do that too. So, to get started, Hello Dolly made its Broadway debut in 1964 with music and lyrics by Jerry Herman and a book by Michael Stewart. It was based on the Thornton Wilder 1938 farce. It was first called A Day Well Spent, and then it was called The Merchant of Yonkers, and then finally it was called The Matchmaker, which is what everybody's pretty familiar with. The musical follows the story of Dolly Gallagher Levi, a strong-willed widowed matchmaker, as she travels to Yonkers, New York. By the way, Yonkers is my hometown. And she goes to Yonkers, New York to find a match for the miserly, well-known, unmarried, half a millionaire, Horace Vandegelder. It had a cast of over 40 people and more than a 30-piece orchestra. It was one of Broadway's greatest extravaganzas. So we're going to go right into one of the greatest songs. Yvette, let's pull up those lyrics. Here we go. Out there's a world outside of Yonkers. Way out there beyond this hick town, Barnaby. There's a slick town, Barnaby. Out there. Full of shine and full of sparkle.
Close your eyes and see it glisten, Barnaby. Listen, Barnaby. Sing along. Here we go. Put on your Sunday clothes. There's lots of world out there. Get out the brilliantine and dime cigars. We're gonna find adventure in the evening air. Girls in white in a perfume night where the lights are bright as the stars. Put on your Sunday clothes, we're gonna ride through town in one of those new horse-drawn open cars. We'll see the shows at Delmonico's and we'll close the town in a whirl. And we won't come home until we've kissed a girl. Next verse. Put on your Sunday clothes when you feel down and down. Strut down the street and have your picture took. Just like a dream, your spirit seemed to turn about. That Sunday shine is a certain sign that you feel as fine as you look. Beneath your parasol, the world is all a smile that makes you feel brand new down to your toes. Get out your feathers, your patent leathers, your beads and buckles and bows, for the snow blue Monday in your Sunday clothes. Hello Dolly debuted at the Fisher Theater in Detroit in November of 1963. It was directed and choreographed by Gower Champion and produced by David Merrick. It moved to Broadway in 1964, winning 10 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. And this set a record, which the play held for 37 years and was beat in 2001 by The Producers, which won 12 Tony Awards. It was also made into a 1969 film from 20th Century Fox, starring the fabulous Barbara Streisand and Walter Matthau. It won 3 Academy Awards, including Best Score, and was nominated in 4 other categories, including Best Musical. Now, the role of Dolly Gallagher Levi was originally written for Ethel Merman, but she turned it down. And then it went to Mary Martin, who also turned it down, although both eventually played Dolly. Producer David Merrick was then auditioned Nancy Walker, but eventually hired Carol Channing into what would be her signature role. Director Gower Champion was also not the producer's first choice, but Hal Prince and Jerome Robbins also turned it down to create one of history's greatest musicals with a very large cast that also featured Eileen Brennan, Charles Nelson Reilly, and a cast, as I said, of over 45 people. Last verse, here we go. Put on your Sunday clothes, there's lots of world out there. We're gonna find adventure in the evening air. To town we'll track to a smoky spot where the girls are hot as a meal. Put on your high steel hat and at the turn of thumb, we'll wear a handmade gray suede button glove. We'll join the Astors and Tony Pastors, and this I'm positive of. And we won't come home. No, we won't come home. No, we won't come home until we fall. Job, everybody. Okay. So the show was originally called A Damned Exasperating Woman, and then Call on Dolly, and then eventually David Merrick, the producer, changed it upon hearing Louis Armstrong's recording of the title song Hello Dolly, which came out before the musical was even released, as it was in the day. Those songs that were written by those Tin Pan Alley theatrical composers
were often given to singers of the time, Frank Sinatra, Louis Armstrong, Ella Fitzgerald, Judy Garland, in order to create a buzz around the musical. So here's our great Carol Channing, who played the role, and she went on to do four revivals of that. So Hello Dolly played for 2,844 performances in its initial run, which also made it, for about 10 years, the longest running show on Broadway, but it was eventually unseated by Grease. Now the list of Dollies is very long. Of course, we have Carol Channing and Mary Martin and Ethel Merman and Pearl Bailey. Pearl Bailey played, let's see if you can see that. She played it in an all African-American cast for which she eventually won a Tony. Let's see, the other people are Tova Feldshuh, and in the recent revival, there was Betty Buckley, Bette Midler, Donna Murphy, Bernadette Peters, and then add to that some of our other favorite actresses, Dorothy L'Amour, Eve Arden, Ann Miller, Michelle Lee, Betty White, Lainey Kazan, Yvonne DiCarlo, Phyllis Diller, Betty Grable, Ginger Rogers, Martha Ray, and almost Liberace. The show opens on a beautiful street scene in Yonkers, my hometown, as we see the villagers milling about on a bright, sunny day. Call on Dolly. She's the one the spinsters recommend. Just name the kind of man your sister wants and she'll snatch them up. Don't forget your maiden aunts and tracks and she'll match them up. Call on Dolly if your eldest daughter needs a friend. Now we're going to talk a little bit about the opening numbers, so if you can hold up this lyric sheet here for a little while, Yvette, that would be great. So the Broadway show in its original form opened with a song called Call on Dolly, which was sung by the chorus. And Dolly made one of those surprise entrances and you didn't know it was her. And then all of a sudden she turns around and there she is. And she sings another part of the song called I Put My Hand In. Well, when Barbara Streisand was announced to do the movie, she wanted a brand new song written for her, and Jerry Herman was so happy to accommodate her. And so for the movie version, he wrote the opening song called Just Leave Everything to Me. If you want your sister courted, brother wed, or cheese imported, just leave everything to me. If you want your roof inspected, eyebrows, tweezers, or bills collected, just leave everything to me. If you want your daughter dated or some marriage consummated for a rather modest fee. If you want a husband spotted, boyfriend chased, or chicken potted, I'll arrange for making all arrangements. Just leave everything to me. So this song effectively replaced the Call on Dolly and I Put My Hand In from the Broadway production. But if we take a listen to it, Put My Hand In, you'll notice that the lyrics and the intent are very, very similar. I have always been a woman who arranges things from the pleasure and the profit it derives. I have always been a woman who arranges things like a furniture and a daffodils and lies. When a man with a timid tongue meets a girl with a diffident air, why should the tortured creatures always beat around the bush when heaven knows Mother Nature always needs a little push? So I put my hand in here, I put my hand in there. And a girl over 6'3" loves a man who comes up to her ear. Surely it's obvious she'll never be seduced till some kind soul condescends to give her beau a little boost. So I put my hand in there. I put my hand in here. Now, I have only done the show Hello Dolly one time in my life, and I was in the chorus, and I played the girl who was 6'3", although I'm only 5'11", and with my longtime friend Tony Dezio, who truly was only indeed 5'2". Now, of course, the signature song Hello Dolly remains an American standard. Who can resist Dolly Gallagher Levi as she descends the red carpeted stairs wearing that fabulous red sequin dress at the beloved Harmonia Gardens, a restaurant and nightclub that she frequented with her late husband, Ephraim Levi. Before I worked in the theater, I worked for Random House Book Publishers, and I was a special events and meeting planner for them, and I got to travel all over the world. And one of the first places that we got to go to was the Boca Raton Hotel, Raton Hotel Resort and Club in, of course, Florida. And when I arrived, we took a tour of the facility, and next to the meeting spaces was this long, beautiful, red carpeted stairway. And I gasped. And the man who was taking me on the tour said, Oh, are you interested in musical theater at all? And I said, a little. And he said, oh yeah, so that staircase was used in the movie version of Hello Dolly when Barbara made her entrance. And I walked up to the top of that staircase and I made my own entrance. Let's go right to that title song, next page of lyrics. Could imagine that fabulous dress coming down. Seeing all those waiters there happy to see me. Hello, Harry. Well, hello, Louis. It's so nice to be back home where I belong. You're looking swell, Manny. I can tell, Danny. You're still glowing, you're still growing, you're still going strong. I feel the room swaying for the band playing one of my old favorite songs from way back when. So bridge that gap, fellas, find me an empty lap, fellas. Dolly'll never go away again. Next verse, join me. Hello, Dolly. Well, hello, Dolly. It's so nice to have you back where you belong. You're looking swell, Dolly. I can tell, Dolly. You're still glowing, you're still growing, you're still going strong. Let's sway. Feel the room swaying while the band's playing one of your old favorite songs from way back when. So take my rap, fellas, find me an empty lap, fellas. Dolly, you'll never go away again. Now, in 1948, Mac David wrote a song called Sunflower, which was popular enough for Frank Sinatra to make a recording. This brought about a lawsuit because Mr. David claimed that the main four-bar theme for Hello Dolly is a spot-on, note-for-note replica of the song. And the case was settled out of court for $250,000, which was a lot of money at that time. So we'll never know whether Jerry did this unconsciously or deliberately, although I think it was probably unconsciously. But let's take a listen to Sunflower, and so you can decide for yourself. Like, listen to this.
She's a sunflower, she's my sunflower, and I know we'll never part. She's a sunflower, she's my one flower, she's the flower of my heart.
So the song, you can see, is very, very similar to that title song of Hello Dolly, which, you know what? It's just an amazing song. So let's bring it on home and sing the rest of it together. Here we go. Moment to make sure we have a little sip of our beverage. Love to know what everybody's drinking today for our happy hour Broadway Cafe. Now, Hello Dolly, the movie, was released in 1969, and it was produced by 20th Century Fox, and they were bound and determined to get that movie out before the show closed on Broadway. So, as you remember, it starred Barbara Streisand and the fabulous Walter Matthau as the curmudgeon Horace Vandergelder. It was directed by Gene Kelly, choreographed by Michael Kidd, and produced by Ernest Lehman. And the film also starred Michael Crawford, who went on to fame as the Phantom in the Phantom of the Opera, the musical, and Danny Lockin and Tommy Toon in his motion picture debut, and let's see, Marianne McAndrew, E.J. Peeker, and Louis Armstrong even had a much lauded cameo in the musical movie. So among the other actresses that were considered for the coveted role of Dolly, first choice was Elizabeth Taylor, who said no. Then they considered Doris Day and Shirley MacLaine, and even Julie Andrews, who had turned it down. Now, Carol Channing, you know Carol, who originated the role on Broadway, she was not considered a bankable Broadway star, excuse me, a bankable Hollywood star. And Barbara was kind of up and coming. Barbara was kind of up and coming at the time. And so she got the job. Now, this was not a popular choice. It was kind of a scandal for a lot of reasons. She was only 26 years old. And she was playing a role that was written to be played by a woman of a certain age, which meant over 40. And but Barbara was under contract, and it was her first $1 million role. And $1 million in 1969 is a lot of money. It's a lot of money now. So although the setting for Hello Dolly is in Yonkers, and again, I grew up in Yonkers, the film for the movie was not, it was not filmed in Yonkers. It was filmed in a beautiful town in Upper Westchester called Garrison. It's on the Hudson River. It's this quaint, lovely little town that was further beautified by 20th Century Fox. They spent more than $500,000 to beautify that town. I'm going to show you a couple of pictures. First of all, the Yonkers Railway Station was actually the garrison's own railway station. And some of the movie set remains in Garrison to this day, including the gazebo in Waterfront Park and the fake barbershop facade. It's really, it's a lovely trip. There's beautiful little restaurants and stuff like that if anybody wants a day trip. Let's see, Horace Vandegelder's store was the Garrison Bed and Breakfast Inn called the Golden Eagle. And on the front doors, the movie company had embossed a golden V, and that still is on the bed and breakfast doors to this day. The church scene at the end of the film was filmed at West Point, of all things. For everything else, 20th Century Fox spent $2 million to create a fabulous turn of the century New York set on their back lot. They got their money's worth. It was used in many, many movies, including Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. And of course it was used for Hello Dolly for all of those fabulous New York street scenes, including when Cornelius Hackle and Barnaby Tucker, Irene Malloy, and Minnie Faye walk almost 100 blocks from the railway station to the fabulous Harmonia Gardens in order to have a nice dinner together. And while they do that, they sing the song Elegance. And I'm going to ask Yvette to put up those lyrics, and you can sing along a little bit with me. Here we go.
Yes, New York, it's really us, Barnaby and Cornelius. All the guests of Mr. Hackle are feeling great and look spectacular. What a knack there is to that, acting like a born aristocrat. We've got elegance. If you ain't got elegance, you can never, ever carry it over.
Let's do another verse together, shall we?
All who are well-bred agree, Minnie Faye has pedigree. Exercise your wildest guess tonight. We are out with diamond juice tonight. Could they be misleading us? Silver spoons were used for feeding us. We got elegance. If you ain't got elegance, you can never, never carry it over.
So perhaps the larger backstory about the movie of Hello Dolly was all of the tension that was on the set. So Streisand was in a feud the entire time with Walter Matthau and also with Gene Kelly, the director, because she didn't respect him as a director. And Gene Kelly was in a feud with Michael Kidd, the choreographer, and Michael Kidd was also in a feud with the costume designer, the hair designer, and the makeup designer, because he wanted all of his dances to be featured. So it was no secret that Walter and Barbara had a big, big feud. We're not going to finish the end of Elegance, Yvette. Sorry, I didn't tell you that sooner. Walter Matthau was an Academy Award winning actor, and he felt that it was degrading for him to play opposite this 26-year-old diva who hadn't really proved herself because Funny Girl hadn't yet come out. So anyway, they worked together, and it was the things that they said about each other were unrepeatable in this forum, but if you want to find out, you can read Jerry Herman's biography, and there's also a really great fair and festival that happens in Garrison, New York every year, and it's got all the backstories of Hello Dolly. So their argument, their tension came to a head, believe it or not, after the unfortunate assassination of Robert F. Kennedy, and Walter Matthau vowed that he would never speak to her again. Now, when it came time for their wedding scene and when they had to kiss at the end of the movie, Walter Matthau refused to do it. And so Gene Kelly had to come up with several different camera angles in order for them to make it look as though their lips are actually touching, but they never did. Walter Matthau also had a, oh, before I go on to that, Walter and Barbara, they made up. So they did mend their fences, and Walter Matthau became a big supporter of her in her later years and attending many, many of her concerts. So you never know. Now, Walter Matthau, you know, he played the curmudgeon Horace Vandegelder, and you know, sometimes art imitates life. I understand that he was a very, very laid back man in real life, very serious actor, but he was kind of laid back and kind of funny. But he had a feud with another actor on the set, Michael Crawford. Michael Crawford, who played Cornelius Hackle, and again, went on to become the first Phantom in the Phantom of the Opera. And on a day off from filming, they went to a racetrack to the horse races. They went to Yonkers Raceway, which still stands today. And while they were there, there was a horse named Hello Dolly. And Walter, am I allowed to call him Walter? Walter Matthau refused to bet on the horse because he hated Barbara so much, but Michael did and won a lot of money. And so therefore Walter said, I am never speaking to you again. And he didn't for the rest of the entire filming. Now, Hello Dolly is at its heart a love story. And as we all know, love stories, fact or fiction, can often be a very bumpy ride. Now, the subplot of Hello Dolly involves two couples. Two couples, let's see, where are they? Two couples, Cornelius Hackle and Barnaby Tucker meet Irene Malloy and Minnie Fay. And Irene Malloy runs a hat shop in New York City. Minnie Fay is her assistant. And so originally, Irene Malloy was promised sight unseen to Horace Vandegelder by the matchmaker, Dolly Gallagher Levi. But complications ensue, as they often do in the world of musical theater. And so when Irene Malloy meets Cornelius Hackle, who has voiced earlier that he will not leave New York until he kisses a girl, it is Irene Malloy who he kisses as the two fall in love at first sight. And then Barnaby Tucker and Minnie Fay, the 18-year-old assistants of Cornelius and Irene, also develop a fondness and a crush for each other and are very smitten. And then after this big chaotic dance number that occurs at the Harmonia Gardens in New York City, where they are all having dinner, they are thrown into jail. Our two couples are thrown into jail along with everybody else at the dinner. And Cornelius Hackle, in a comical but poignant moment, shares this song. And we're gonna go to the next song, Yvette. You'll like this one, it's a pretty ballad.
It only takes a moment for your eyes to meet, and then your heart knows in a moment you will never be. Help me for an instant.
Dolly Broadway show producer, David Merrick, was a hit maker on Broadway, but he was a difficult, difficult man. And that's why they call it show business, folks, and not show fun. His nickname was the Abominable Showman. And it's also the title of his biography, which I highly recommend. Now, Hello Dolly was Jerry Herman's first, you know, real legitimate job. And David Merrick was worried that Jerry was not going to be up to the task. Hello Dolly had had a very troubled tryout out of town in Detroit. And so behind Jerry's back, David Merrick called in some other composers in case Jerry wasn't going to be able to cut it. Now, among the composers that he brought in, first of all, were Bob Merrill, who either wrote or co-wrote Elegance, which we sang, and the Motherhood March, which takes place early in Act One. He also wrote a version of the song Before the Parade Passes By, which was scrapped for a new song by Jerry Herman with the same title. Charles Strauss of Annie fame was also brought in to write some music, as well as Lee Adams, who wrote music for Bye Bye Birdie. Each of them worked on a song entitled Before the Parade Passes By, and neither Gower Champion or David Merrick cared for any of those versions, so they ultimately decided to give it to Jerry Herman to see if he could take it. Now, the original end of Act One of Hello Dolly ends with a terrific song called Penny in My Pocket, which was sung by Horace Vandegelder. And although, as I said, it's a great song, it really kind of played up the character of Horace, and the audiences wanted more Dolly. So Jerry Herman was charged at 11 p.m. that night to come up with a new song. And he was up to the task and fit the bill because he created the song Before the Parade Passes By in 3 hours. And he called up Gower Champion and Carol Channing and put the song into the show the next day. And it's remained that way ever since. Now, you never know how shows are going to affect us. So, when I had, stay with me here, when I had my colonoscopy, my sister and I decided to have them on the same day and make it a family event. And so she went into her room and I went into my room. And when I got in there, I got acquainted with everybody. You know, if you know me, I'm kind of friendly. I like to talk to people. And the nurses knew me, blah, blah, blah. So after a short while, the anesthesiologist came in and he's going through his papers, very, very official. And he goes, oh, it says here that you're on singular. I said, I'm not on singular. And he goes, well, that's what it says here. And so finally the nurse says, she's a singer. She's not on singular. And he says, oh, well, what kind of music do you sing? I said, well, I do a lot of cabaret, you know, musical theater. And he got very quiet and he said to me, my dream was to be a chorus boy on Broadway. But my parents told me that they wouldn't pay for my college if I didn't go to medical school. And so I went to medical school and I said, oh my God, that's so amazing. And I said, so what's your favorite show? And what do you think he answered? Hello, Dolly. And I said, oh my gosh, I'm going to see Bette Midler in it. This was, I guess, November of 2017. Bette Midler in it in a few weeks. And so he was so excited and started singing Hello, Dolly right there in the procedure room. And so when we were finished and you go into recovery, out I come singing with the nurse and the anesthesiologist, and my sister says only Valerie could make the hospital staff sing. So if we think about that beautiful song, you like that story? We think about that beautiful song, Before the Parade Passes By. It's Dolly's declaration that she's ready to come back to life. And so let's pull that up, Yvette. And we're gonna round out our day today, our time together. Let's make sure we have a little sip and a toast together. And we're going to start our song.
I put a pen.
Here we go. Here we go.
For the parade passes by, I'm gonna go and taste Saturday's highlight. Before the parade passes by, I'm gonna get some life back into my life. I'm ready to move out in front. I've had enough of just passing by life. With the rest of them, with the best of them, I can hold my head up high. For I've got a goal again, I've got a drive again. I want to feel my heart coming alive again before the parade passes by.
A big thank you to Rogers Memorial Library and the John Germain Library and the Hampton Library and Shelter Island Library, a joint effort that was spearheaded by the always wonderful Penny Wright. And of course, a big thank you to Yvette. We could not have done this without you today. And thank you to all of you for spending your Tuesday afternoon. I'm gonna give you a toast. And I'll be back in August, August 17th with Ladies of Liberty, celebrating the 100th centennial of women's suffrage. And then we're hoping to do more Broadway cafes in the fall. So make sure you let us know what some of your favorite musicals are. And until then, please be safe and well. And let's finish out the song, Yvette. Here we go. When the parade passes by, listen and hear that brass harmony grow. When the parade passes by, pardon me if my own spirit is showing. All of those lights over there seem to be telling me where I'm going. When the whistles blow, and the cymbals crash, and the sparklers light the sky, I'm gonna raise the roof, I'm gonna carry on. Give me an old trombone, give me an old baton, before the parade passes by. Woo! Let's unmute ourselves and go to gallery view.
Thank
you. See everybody. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Good to see you. Let me hear you. Oh, there's Penny and Terrence.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone.
Thank you.
Kathy,
that was great.
Mary, Barbara, Leslie. Hi, Glorian. Nice to see you. Hi, Diana.
And hi, Leslie. Thank you.
Hi, Jocelyn.
Hi, Valerie. Thank you.
It's so nice to see you. Hi, Penny and Yvette. Thank you so much. And let's see, Lindsay Gamble is hiding herself. Everybody, thank you so much. It was such a lovely pleasure to be with you today.
I look forward to
thank you.
Beautiful questions. Thank you, Valerie.
Thank you.
Thank you, Valerie.
Thank you, everybody. Have
thank
a great
you, Penny.
Day, okay?
Thank you, Yvette.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye now.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Everybody stay safe.
Stay safe. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye now.